Hello students, hope you all are well. Welcome to the channel Easy Recall. This channel is programmed for the purpose of helping the students to do regular revision and memorize properly all the subjects following the books of different boards. You can choose the videos related to your boards and the subjects and books which you follow to complete your syllabus. You can send your books in PDF format in my email ID so that I can make a revision and recall video from it. Kindly do not send personal study notes or private tuition notes. Only send books in PDF format to my Gmail ID banerjeeandila@gmail.com. Thank you for listening carefully. Let's start now today's subject. Concise Biology ICC Part 2 Class 10 Revised and Enlarged by H.S. Bisnoy, edited by Ms. Mary Fernandez and Dr. Preeti Srivastava, Selena Publishers Private Limited. Second part of Chapter 2, Structure of Cell. Find the cell cycle. The cell cycle is a series of events that take place in a cell leading to the duplication of its DNA and the subsequent division of the cell to produce two daughter cells. I repeat, what is the definition of cell cycle? The cell cycle is a series of events that take place in a cell leading to the duplication of its DNA and the subsequent division of the cell to produce two daughter cells. Now, what are the phases that a cell cycle consists of? A cell cycle consists of two phases. First, a non-dividing phase called interphase, and second, a dividing phase called the M phase, or simply mitosis. The next question is, what do you mean by interphase? The answer is, the two daughter cells produced from a mother cell are relatively small with a full-sized nucleus but relatively little cytoplasm. These cells are said to be an interphase. During this phase, they prepare for the next cell division and grow to the same size as their mother cell. Since no change in chromosomes is visible externally during the interphase, formerly it was called resting phase of the cell. But in reality, it is not true, as the cell is quite active during interphase in synthesizing more DNA. Now, what are the phases under interphase? The answer is, the interphase itself has three phases. First is the growth phase, second is the synthesis phase, and the third is the second growth phase. Now discuss about first growth phase, that is G1. In case of first growth phase, that is G1, RNA and proteins are synthesized and the volume of cytoplasm increases. Mitochondria in animal cells and chloroplasts in plant cells divide. These two organelles have their own DNA. In late G1 phase, all cells must follow one of the two paths. They may either withdraw from the cell cycle and enter a resting phase, that is capital R, or start preparing for the next division by entering the next synthesis phase denoted by capital S. Now, second is the synthesis phase. More DNA is synthesized in this phase and the chromosomes are duplicated. Third is the second growth phase, denoted by capital G, base 2. This is a shorter growth phase in which RNA and proteins necessary for cell division continue to be synthesized. Now the cell is ready to undergo cell division and enter the dividing phase of the cell cycle. After the dividing phase gets completed, the newly formed daughter cells enter into interphase again, and in this way the cell cycle goes on and on. Figure 2.8 from your book Cell Cycle. Formation of the new DNA. During the S phase of the interphase, each DNA molecule, that is chromosome, duplicates in readiness for their equitable distribution in the two daughter cells during mitosis. For replication, the DNA double helix opens at one end, making the two strands free, to which new strands begin to form, and the process continues in a sequence for the whole length of the DNA. The entire replication is a very complicated process which you will study in detail in higher classes. Now see the picture, figure number 2.9 in your book, Replication of DNA. Now the question is, can the cell cycle go on endlessly? No. At some places it stops permanently, at some places temporarily, and at others till it is needed. There is a regulatory mechanism for cell cycles. Brain and other nerve cells, once formed in the embryo, do not divide further. Once dead, they are not replaced. Liver cells may divide only once every 1 to 2 years to replace damaged or destroyed cells. Surface skin cells are continuously lost and replaced by the underlying cells. A large portion of household dust contains human skin cells, the powdery material that comes off from your skin on scratching on or on hard rubbing while bathing contains some dead cells. In plants, the cells at the growing points, meristems, divide very rapidly and produce new leaves, buds and flowers, etc. Specialized germinal cells in the ovary and testes in animals, and in the ovary and anthers in plants, undergo the other type of cell division called meiosis to produce sex cells. Uncontrolled non-stop cell cycles may lead to tumors that may or may not be cancerous. Cell production and cell death. As children, we grow because new cells are continuously being produced and they outnumber the dying cells. When we are adults, our cell population stays constant. The number of new cells produced equals the number of cells dying. As we grow old, the number of new cells produced runs short of those that are dying. Cell division. There are two types of cell divisions: mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis, cell division leading to the production of diploid cells for growth and development. Now, what is meiosis? Cell division leading to the production of haploid cells or gametes, that is sperms or egg, are called meiosis. In the word mitosis, mitos means thread, which refers to the chromatin thread. Mitosis is the cell division in which one parent cell divides into two identical daughter cells. The most important aspect of mitosis is that the same normal chromosome number is maintained at each cell division. Now, what are the phases of mitosis? Mitosis is completed in two steps, karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Karyokinesis, that is division of nucleus. Karyokinesis of mitosis occurs in four main phases, although each of these phases merges into the next phase, thereby making it a continuous process. The four phases of mitosis are prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. By and large, the four phases of mitosis are similar in both animal and plant cells. However, we are first describing the mitotic stages in an animal cell. Figure 2.10 illustrates these stages in animal and plant cells side by side. Major differences in the mitosis of plant and animal cells have been listed in Table 2.1. Number 1. Prophase. Pro means first. The chromosomes have become short and thick and are clearly visible inside the nucleus. Each chromosome has already duplicated, that is having made its copy to form two chromatids. The two sister chromatids remain attached to each other at a small region called centromere. The centrosome in animal cell splits into two along with simultaneous duplication of the centrioles contained in it. The daughter centrioles move apart and occupy opposite poles of the cell. Each centriole is surrounded by radiating rays and is termed aster. Aster means star. The animal cells may have either one or two centrioles. A number of fibers appear between the two daughter centrioles, which are called the spindle fibers. The nuclear membrane and the nucleus disappear. The duplicated chromosomes start moving towards the equator of the cell. Note, poles mean the extremities of an axis, and equator means the middle plane dividing the cell into two similar halves. The naturally occurring cells may be oriented in all possible directions. Now, what is metaphase? Meta means after. The duplicated chromosomes arrange on the equatorial plane. Each chromosome gets attached to a spindle fiber by its centromere. Interphase. Resting phase. No visible change in chromosomes, but active synthesis of DNA. Prophase. A and B. Centrioles start moving apart and reach opposite poles. Chromosomes become distinct. Chromosomes are already duplicated as paired chromatids. Sister chromatids attached to each other at a small region called centromere. Spindle fibers appear between daughter centrioles, forming the achromatic spindle. Nuclear membrane and nucleus disappear. Metaphase, that is C phase. Each chromosome gets attached to spindle by its centromere. Chromosomes line up in one plane at equator. Anaphase, that is phase D and E. Centromere attaching the two chromatids divides or splits. The two sister chromatids of each chromosome separate and are drawn apart towards opposite poles, pulled by shortening of spindle fibers. A furrow starts in the cell membrane at the middle in animal cell. Now watch the structure of animal cell and plant cell from your book, figure number 2.10. Telophase, phase F. Two sets of daughter chromosomes reach opposite poles. Spindle fibers disappear. Chromatids thin out in the form of chromatin fibers. Nuclear membrane is formed. The cleavage furrow starts deepening in the animal cell. Nucleoli reappear. Cytokinesis, division of cytoplasm. Cleavage furrow deepens totally in animal cell and separates the two daughter cells. Now starts anaphase. Ana means up or back. The centromere attaching the two chromatids divides, and the two sister chromatids of each chromosome separate and are drawn apart towards opposite poles. The drawing action is performed by the contraction of spindle fibers. Telophase. Telo means end. Each chromatid or the daughter chromosome lengthens, becomes thinner, and turns into a network of chromatin threads. Nuclear membrane reappears. Nucleus reappears in each daughter nucleus. All the contents of the cytoplasm, including the mitochondria and also the chloroplast in plant cell, are randomly distributed in the daughter cells during karyokinesis. Cytokinesis, division of cytoplasm. At the end of telophase, a furrow appears in the cell membrane in the middle, which deepens and finally splits the cytoplasm into two, thus producing two new cells. Karyokinesis and cytokinesis. All the nuclear changes that occur during cell division are collectively termed karyokinesis. Karyo means nucleus. Karyokinesis is followed by the division of cytoplasm, that is cytokinesis. Differences in mitosis in animal and plant cells. The nuclear and chromosomal events of mitosis in plant cells are the same as those in animal cells. See figure 2.10. But some differences are as follows. Now watch the table number 2.1 in your book. In table 2.1, it shows differences between mitosis in animal and plant cell. Number 1, in case of animals, asters are formed, but in case of plants, asters are not formed. In case of animals, cytokinesis by furrowing of cytoplasm, the furrow starts from the cell membrane, which then proceeds to the center of the cell. But in case of plants, cytokinesis is happened by cell plate formation. The cell plate is laid down at the center of the cell, which then grows and extends towards the cell membrane. In animals, occurs in most tissues throughout the body for growth and replacement. And in plants, mitosis occurs mainly at the growing tips for lengthening and in sides for increasing in girth. For today, this video ends here, and the last part will be uploaded in the next video. Thank you.